the most interesting things that I've seen in Judge Kavanaugh's record from the D.C. Circuit are the instances where he broke from his colleagues, including conservative colleagues, and then was chided actually by those conservative colleagues for taking an overly aggressive approach to the law. For example, in the campaign finance case involving Emily's list, with which Roman mentioned earlier, he was chided by his colleague for going even further in his broad constitutional ruling than was required, even broader in striking down campaign finance limits than the plaintiffs themselves asked for. And then also in a case that Senator Harris mentioned about Judge Kavanaugh would have ruled that undocumented workers are excluded from the important protections of the National Labor Relations Board. He was chided there for going against Supreme Court precedent, chided by a conservative colleague. And so that's when he's on the lower court. He goes beyond Supreme Court precedent, contradicts Supreme Court precedent in some ways, according to his own conservative colleagues. So there's a real concern about what will he do when he's on the high court, when he actually has the ability as a Supreme Court justice to strike down even longstanding precedent. I think it's slightly unclear whether his views have shifted over time, depending on who's in the White House. And that's why I think it's really important in this hearing that we get substantive answers from Brett Kavanaugh on the meaning of the Constitution. You know, he doesn't have to say, how would you rule in the case exactly of indicting President Trump? But it's totally legitimate to ask him, and I think he should, the American people should put pressure on senators to make sure that he answers questions about, do you think a president can be investigated or indicted or must respond to a subpoena while he's in office? That's about what the Constitution means. And I think that that's something that he should explain to us. That's something that we saw from Justice Ginsburg in her confirmation hearing. She wouldn't respond about particular cases, but she was very clear about what the meaning of equality and liberty meant for women wishing to choose abortion. So I hope we get substantive answers to clarify that.
Is there any precedent, Elizabeth? I mean, I'll ask all three of you. Is there a precedent for someone nominated to the Supreme Court to be pressed for his or her views on a question like this, that where we're not talking about a specific Supreme Court decision?
There absolutely is precedent in terms of asking a nominee about his or her understanding
asking,
of the Constitution.
But answering, maybe.
Oh, yes, yes, absolutely. I mean, not quite in these such controversial and heated times. You know, several senators noted that this is a unique confirmation hearing because of the uniqueness of Trump presidency and the scandal that, you know, has enveloped it. So that makes this unique. But it is certainly very appropriate, and the questions have been asked and answered about how nominees view the Constitution. Sometimes they don't want to criticize a particular case or not, but Gorsuch spoke about the Fourth Amendment. Ginsburg spoke about the 14th Amendment. So it's happened.